हेलो फ्रेंड्स, माय नेम इज सुमन गंगोपाध्याय। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सी हाउ टू डेवलप आवर फर्स्ट पाइथन गेम यूजिंग द पाई गेम मॉड्यूल ऑफ पाइथन। ओके, सो टू यूज पाई गेम मॉड्यूल इन पाइथन वी हैव टू इंस्टॉल पाइथन फर्स्ट। आई एम यूजिंग पाइथन वर्जन 3.5 एंड वी आर गोइंग टू इंस्टॉल पाई गेम मॉड्यूल फर्स्ट। So to install Pygame module, we have to go to the command prompt. As you can see, my command prompt window is on my desktop right now, and we are going to install Pygame. So to the command to run Pygame is pip install Pygame. So pip is the Python installation program. Okay. So it is going to install the Pygame module from the Python repository. Okay, as you can see that it is giving me requirements already satisfied. This message is given when Pygame is already being installed in your system. So in my computer right now, Pygame is installed and it is ready to go. Now, after installing your Pygame like this, you have to verify that Pygame is really working or not. So you have to go to your Python shell. So you went go to the Python shell by writing the Python, just write the Python. And as you can see, I am working with Python 3.5.2 version. Okay, so and it's a 32-bit Python. So here I am going to write import pygame. So you can see that when I wrote import pygame and pressed enter, it didn't give me any error messages. That means Python pygame module is being installed in my system. Very good. Now you have to get out of the Python shell, and I have a program. Okay. This Pygame one, and I'm going to run it, and I'm going to tell you how to create this first Pygame module for your Python game development. So this is my Python window that I have created. Now you guys have to learn first how to create the graphical user interface for Python game development using Pygame, and it is our first lesson of today. So we are going to see it. Okay, so here you can see that it's a black and white window that is being seen over here. So we are going to develop this window. This is one of the most important thing that has to be developed when you are going to create a Python game module. Whether you are going to create chess, whether you are going to create a Ludo or something like a kind of game. So in the coming days, we are going to create some awesome games in Python also. So I'm going to tell you how to develop those things and those logic as well. So let us now develop this basic window of Python. Okay. So let me close it. Now to develop a Python game module, you can use any text editors. Okay, but I would request you that you use PyCharm, created by JetBrains. It is the community version, so I am going to use it up over here. So it's loading right now. So until it loads, I'm going to pause this video and then I'm going to come back to you. So my PyCharm community version editor is right now going to be on my screen with all its usage. It's loading. So it takes a bit of a time, need not to worry. Okay, so let it load first because it uses Gradle, and this Gradle is a stuff that is used in the Android the developing tool SDK also. So it takes a bit of a time. Need not to worry. Have patience, and it's still working. It's scanning and installing all the packages of Python. It's an awesome IED. Sorry, it's not IED, it's IDE. I beg a pardon of you. So create a new project. My game would be Pygames. Okay, so my location of this project would be user Broken Angel PyCharm projects Pygames, and it is using the Python editor version 3.5.2. Now this is my project has been created. What I will do, I will create a file here. So I will right click this Pygame project which has created, and in the new I'm going to have a Python file over here. I'm going to write this file as write the name of the file as Suman, let it be camel case Python game 1, and just press OK. That's it. So now you are going to write your first Python program. Congratulations. So the first thing you're going to do, you're going to import the Pygame module. Okay, so you have to write Pygame, import Pygame. Then you are going to import the sys module also of Python. After doing so, write from pygame dot locals import star. So pygame dot in the pygame module there's a class of locals, and from that class we are going to import all the methods. It's a very big module, and it comprises of many classes and functions and all those kinds of things. So we are going to do so. One thing I'm going to tell you, friends, that after writing import Python, you have to write import sys, because the function of this sys module is to gain access of all the Python system modules. Because when we are creating a window in Python, we want to use all the system based functions which Python gives by default to the operating systems. For example, the window needs to be closed, it needs to be minimized. So those kinds of functions are present in the sys module of Python. So we have imported the sys module. Okay, very good. Now every Pygame module has to be initialized, and this is the first function you are going to write, pygame.init. Okay, after writing this pygame.init, you have to create a object of display, and that object is going to call pygame.display.setMode. Now this is the best function of using the PyCharm, you know, it gives you a bit of help. Okay, so setMode. Now I'm going to give you tell you why it is so. What is set mode and all those kinds of things? Actually, it's a tuple. It takes a tuple, and this Python dot display dot set mode is the window size of your Python game module. So here, since it's a tuple, it should be in the round brackets. So I'm going to use 500 by 400. Okay. So it should be x and y. So 500 is the x coordinate and 400 would be the y coordinate. Okay, so it would be the length and breadth of the whole window would be 500 by 400. This is the meaning of this thing. Now after doing so, we are going to write Python dot display. Now before writing this line, let us run this code. Okay, to run this code in PyCharm, you have to go to run and just click the run button. It is going to tell which file you are going to run. So I have right now a Suman Python game 1 file. I'm going to click it up, and you can see You can see, you just saw the window, that it's a 500 by 400 window and there is no captions over here. I am again going to tell you. Okay. See, Python game window it is written. Now we have to write something in that caption. To write something in the caption, you need to write pygame dot display dot set caption, and I am going to write hello friends from Suman Mukhopadhyay. Okay, so I have set the caption for this window as Python hello friends from Suman Gangopadhyay. I am again going to run it. So here, hello friends from Suman Gangopadhyay. Again, I'm going to show you. Okay, hello friends from Suman Gangopadhyay. Now there is a bit of a glitch in this program. The glitch is that the window comes and it, in a moment, it disappears. You can say in a modicum of time, it gets disappeared. Okay, so we have to stop it up. That means when we click the this cross button, when the window get closed. Now we are going to work on it. Now every Python game has a main loop, and that main loop is a while true loop. Okay, while true, sorry. So whenever you try to run create a Python game using pygame, you always have to write if your main functions, classes, whatever, everything in this while true loop. That is very important to do so. Okay, now in this while loop I'm going to write for event in pygame dot event dot get. Now this is your main loop. While true is your main loop. Under this loop you are going to write your whole program. You should remember this thing, and this is very important. It is very imperative. Now when this loop is working, when the loop is true, it's not false, I'm going to write an event, and that event is for event in pygame dot event dot get. Okay, after writing, so what I need to do, if the event dot type equal to quit, that means if I click this button in the window your program is going to stop. That means pygame dot quit. Now after doing so, sys dot exit and pygame dot display dot update. That's it. So this is your main loop, while loop, and for events in pygame.event.get, that means whenever when this while loop is true and not false, some event is going to get executed. And what that event is, when that event is when someone presses this red button on your game, the window get closed. So let us run this thing. See, now this window doesn't vanishes in a speck of time. It remains. Why it remains? Because I have written this for loop. Under this for loop, the whole event is written, that when someone quits it, when someone presses this button, the window closes. So this is how you are going to create the first program in your pygame using Python, and this is the very important milestone of your game development in Python, because you need to create the window first. You need to understand how this window is created. It is a 400, 500. It is a 500 by 400 window, and the caption is set to "Hello friends from Suman Gangopadhyay." You can see over there. And when I press this close button, the window closes and the program stops to function. So this is how, guys, you are able to create your first Python program. And I hope you are going to practice it more and more, because it is very necessary that you practice for if you want to become a game developer in Python. So till next time, happy coding, happy Python coding. Bye, take care.